Learning how to deal with grief is a life lesson that takes time, but as our next guest knows all too well, it's a natural, intense, and universal process. Author and spiritual life coach Misty Thompson joins me to talk about her new book, From Grief to Acceptance. Such a pleasure to have
you here.
Thank you
so much. It's great to be here.
And it's a serious topic, one that we all go through and one that we have to learn from.
Absolutely.
Right? Because you lost somebody very close to you 25 years ago. So talk about who you lost and what that process of grieving taught you about grief.
Right. Well, back in 1993, I lost my sister, Stephanie. She was missing for 55 days, and her remains were found in southeastern Arizona in the Safford area. And during that whole process, I never really lost anyone close to me. And it took me 20 plus years to really open up and realize we all go through the grieving process, and it's a natural part of life. It's inevitable. Mm-hmm. And it's something that people push down and they don't deal with it and they stay stuck.
Well, and when they do push it down, and even sometimes when they don't, it manifests itself in physical ways and emotional ways.
Yes.
So talk about that.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we all, no matter what it is, whether it's grief, guilt, whatever it is, that's those heavy, dark emotions, mm-hmm. when you push it down, it has to come forward somehow, some way. And I have found, even in my own personal life, that, and part of it was the grief, it does come in the form of physical ailments. Mm-hmm. It is, the body has a way of getting rid of those dark emotions.
And you talk about something called honoring your emotions,
absolutely.
Right? What does that mean for
people
every day?
For honoring, that's what the book is about. It's honoring our loved ones. When our loved ones pass away, I choose to believe that my sister wants me to live a life that's fulfilling, fearless, and not stuck in grief. So by me living the best version of myself, I'm able to honor my sister. And to me, that's what it's all about. And it's not only my sister. You know, I've had grandmothers, we've all had grandparents, mm-hmm. and they want us to succeed. They want us to live a life that's full and to learn from that and treat others that are here on earth mm-hmm. with us with respect
right.
and love.
Right, and those past loved ones would want us to turn that grief into hope, like you're saying, and make it a transformational situation. So what are three quick ways that someone can honor the memory of their past loved ones?
These are great ways that work with me. One is to be compassionate to yourself. Mm-hmm. You know, anytime you have any grief, as far as it manifesting into guilt, that kind of thing, just release it, you know. It's time to push those away. So just honor yourself and your loved one by being open with yourself, being compassionate towards yourself. You know, spending time with yourself as in the form of meditation or prayer, you know, that is so huge. And it's great to come inside yourself and honor yourself that way. And just look at everything that your loved ones have offered you.
Mm-hmm. Right, treat it as a gift, right?
Absolutely.
It's a gift that they gave you.
Sure.
And so you're going on this national book tour to talk about this book. Why is it important in 30 seconds for mm-hmm. you to do it here in Tucson as well?
Well, I'm from Safford, so it's, you know, up southeastern Arizona. My daughter lives here in the Tucson area. You know, I spend a lot of time in Tucson, so it's important that I definitely bring it to Tucson. Mm-hmm. And so I will be at Barnes & Noble at Foothills Mall tomorrow evening, and then on Friday I'll be at Barnes & Noble on Broadway.
Excellent. You really are spreading a very important message for a lot of people, because it's something that we don't talk about often enough is how to deal with that grief.
Right.
So
absolutely.
It's a great book for that, and I let people know when those signings are. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
I appreciate it.
Misty has a couple book signings and discussions happening this week. Tomorrow evening, she'll be at the Barnes & Noble inside the Foothills Mall from 6 to 8 p.m. And on Friday, she'll be at the Barnes & Noble on Broadway from 6 to 8 p.m. If you want more information, visit mistymthompson.com.